student. Welcome to Master Key Yard. Today we shall be looking at a new topic called cost volume profit analysis. Yes, CVPC, or you may call it break-even analysis. Now, cost volume profit analysis is an extension of marginal costing. It is the application of marginal costing to the study of the relationship between the cost, volume, and profit at different levels of activities. We are saying that there is a connection between the cost of production and the volume produced, or unit, or you may call it level of activity, and the profit. It is a very useful guide that the management employs in their short-term planning and decision-making. As a management, you must understand the analysis of the activity you want to embark on. You would ask yourself a question: this particular product that I want to produce, is it profitable? Now, what is the cost? If I produce this, what will be my profit? And at least, you should know that the aim of every management is to make profit. And if we are not even making profit, then we should break even. That is, we should be able to recover our total cost incurred in that production. When you say break even, break even is a situation where the total revenue equals the total cost. Break even is that point where your total revenue equals total cost. It is that point where there is zero profit. It is that point where there is no profit or loss. That is, at break-even point, total revenue equals total cost, give us what? Zero profit. So as management, if I understand the unit to produce to at least break-even, that is good. Then I cannot go further to understand how many units can we produce to achieve a particular level of profit. CVPC uses marginal costing in total. That is, the C, the V, the P. If, for instance, we try to increase the volume of our production, okay? Now, it will have an impact on the cost of production. It will also affect our profit. Number two, if the management decides to reduce the cost of production by producing more volume, it will also have an impact on the profit. So these are some of the uses of cost volume profit analysis to the management. Yeah, you must also understand that there are basic fundamental assumptions for using CVPC. And as a student, you must understand at least 6 or 5 of these basic assumptions. Now, number one, the total cost, okay, can be broken into fixed and variable elements. Number two assumption is that the variable cost per unit is constant. Number three assumption, the total fixed cost remains the same within the relevant range of activity. Number four, there is no uncertainty. Number five, the only factor that affects cost and profit is the volume of production. Number six, the technique, the method, and efficiency is okay. So these are some of the assumptions that we must put into consideration anytime you want to apply cost volume profit analysis. Amen. Now, like I said earlier, that the management should be able to project and to see the consequence of their projections. Now, CVPC will assist the management in answering some questions, yes, such as one, you may call it uses, okay, or importance of CVP. Uses or importance of CVP. One, it helps the management to determine the units to produce in order to break even. So, number two, it helps the management, okay, to understand the level of sales they must achieve to break even. Number three, it helps the management to also understand the units they must produce in order to achieve a particular target profit. Number four, it also helps the management to understand the level of sales they must sell in naira or value to achieve a particular profit. Number five, it helps us to understand the units we must produce and sell in order to achieve a particular profit after tax. As an accounting student, our profit after tax, okay, is what? Profit before tax minus tax. So it can help the management to determine the unit they must produce to achieve a particular profit after tax. Number six, it also helps the management to determine the sales they must make in order to achieve a particular profit after tax. Okay. So these are some of the uses, okay, or some of the questions that CVPC will assist the management to answer. Is that there? Now, there are four basic methods. There are four basic methods of solving CVP analysis. One is mathematical approach. Two, formulae approach. Three, graphical approach. Four, tabular approach. These are the four basic methods, okay, of solving cost volume profit analysis. They will produce the same result. Exactly. But for the sake of this class and for the ICAN students, okay, or the undergraduate students, we shall focus on this approach on the first, second, and third. Exactly.